Hey Rock Kids family, we are so excited to be joining in with you guys today. This is such a special time of the year. It's my favorite time of the year, Christmas time, right? We're gonna be talking all about how Jesus is the reason for the season, right? He's the most special thing. He's the most important thing. So before we get started today, I want you guys to put your hands out. You know what to do, clap them together. Let's bow our heads and close our eyes and let's pray. Dear God, we just thank you, God, for this great day that you've given us, God. We thank you, God, that we get to come together. We get to join in, God, to learn about you, God. Oh, we just thank you for all that you're doing in our lives, God. We thank you for this special time of year, God. I just pray you'd remind each and every single one of us, God, that it's about your son, Jesus, and it's about what you did for us, God. We thank you for the best gift that we could all ask for, which is your son, Jesus, God. I pray that you just bless every single kid, every single family that's watching and that's tuning in today, God. We just thank you for what you're doing in our lives. In Jesus' name I pray, and everybody said, amen.
Rock Kids, it's so good to see you today. We're so excited. You know what time of year it is? It's
Christmas time. We love Christmas. Yes. It's a great time of year. One of my favorite time of year. What's some great things that you love about Christmas?
I thought you'd never ask. Okay. I love Christmas tree decorating. Mm-hmm. I love making baked goods. I made an apple pie just because I was so excited about the season. And I like to shop a little bit. But I also love the candy canes. I keep hanging them on the tree. And
hang them to get a little bit closer to you on the Christmas tree.
I like to eat the candy canes off the tree. They're wonderful.
Right.
I love this time of year. I mean, and then there's the Grinch movie. There's like so much fun. I like
Wait. You haven't mentioned Jesus not one time in all the things that you love about Christmas.
I was getting to that. I really was. That was the next thing I was going to talk about.
Okay, all right. Well,
I love talking about Jesus too. In fact, we've been talking about Jesus's birth all month long. And as we get ready for Christmas Day, do you know what's going to happen on Christmas Eve? We're going to have a Christmas Eve service. Well, this year's a little bit different. We're going to be at home for it, but it's going to happen on Christmas Eve. You get to watch online our special Christmas Eve service at The Rock, and it's going to be wonderful. But do you know something special that's going to happen that night?
I do know something special is going to happen. We as a church are going to take communion at our Christmas Eve service.
Yes.
It's going to be so amazing. It's one of the things that we really love to do, not only as a church, but as our family.
Yes.
We love to do it. It's a very, very important thing.
So this year you get to take communion either like in your Christmas jammies or maybe if you're celebrating with family that night, because some people celebrate Christmas on Christmas
they
Eve.
Do.
You might be all dressed up, but you get to have communion with your family. So we wanted to just explain to you how special it is. You know, Jesus actually served communion with his disciples, and he explained it all to them, but it really represents something super special. It represents what Jesus did for us by dying on the cross. You know, he didn't just come to the earth as a baby, but he died on the cross as an adult for our sins.
He did. He did. At the Last Supper, Jesus blessed the bread, and he broke it, and he handed it to his disciples and said, "Take this, it's my body." And they ate it. And then he picked up the cup and he said, "This is my blood, take and drink." It's important that we remember what Jesus did for us, not only in his birth, but also on the cross.
So when you come into church sometimes, they'll hand you like a little cup and it's got a wafer on top. I know my kids are like, yum. And so sometimes we get this and we don't really know what it means. So I like it that Pastor Jeff explained that the bread actually represents Jesus's body, and the juice actually represents Jesus's blood that was shed for us. So when you get ready to take communion, you may have one of these at your house, but if you don't, we've got a plan B.
You can use Goldfish, or you can use pretzels or crackers, or just kind of whatever you have laying around. When it comes to the juice, you can get this juice or any kind of juice you have, or I've even heard people using Coca-Cola maybe. Maybe not on a right before bedtime, but you can even use Coca-Cola if you need to, but just make sure that you have that stuff available when it comes time for communion.
So the important thing to remember is that this is a special moment for you to remember what really matters when we celebrate Christmas, and that is Jesus. And in this moment, when it's time to get serious and quiet, and mom and dad are gonna be like, you know, be really quiet, be really serious, what can you be thinking about when you are taking the bread and taking the juice? What will you think about, Pastor Jeff, when you're having communion?
I will think about my family. I will think about my children and my wife, and I will think about how awesome it is to celebrate Christmas, that Jesus is the reason for the season.
I'll be thinking about that Jesus did something so amazing for me and for you and for all of us. You know, it kind of gets me teary when I think about it, because he didn't have to do it, but he paid a huge price so that we could be saved. He paid that price for me and for you.
That's right.
For all of us.
That's right.
So I'm going to be thankful for what Jesus has done for us, and I'm also going to be praying for those who still need him in a big, big way. We have friends and family who are sick. We have friends and family who don't know Jesus like we do, and we're going to be praying for them during that time of communion. So I want you guys to get ready. Maybe you have a special cup and you can get it ready for Christmas Eve service. Maybe you've already got crackers in the pantry and you can go ahead and get those ready. Talk to mom and dad and you guys make it a special time. so that you can celebrate Jesus on Christmas Eve. Pastor Jeff, we're going to get all of our things ready for that service too.
Absolutely. But before we go, I'm going to pray over you guys. Ready? Lord Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this time, Lord God, with our family. We thank you, Lord God, that we can set time aside so we can remember the awesome things that you did for us. Lord God, we glorify you. We honor you, Lord God. I pray that you bless everyone, Lord God. We thank you for that. For it's in your name we pray. Amen.
We will see you guys soon. And of course,
Merry Christmas.
It's so good to have you. Could you please just tell us your name?
My name is Pastor Christian. First name Pastor, last name Christian.
Hi, my name is Tim Reyes.
Spencer Bell.
I am Pastor Laura.
Okay, welcome Pastor Jamin. We are so excited to have you here for Scripture Jumble.
Okay.
All right, so when I say go, I am actually going to be recording your time.
Okay.
And whoever does this the fastest and the most correct is going to win the prize.
$1 million.
Another prize.
Okay.
Bragging rights.
A penny.
Yes. All right. So the scripture is Luke 2:14. 1, 2, 3. Go.
Up. Two-wired, men, that has the punctuation at the end. Let's see, peace. Oh gosh, no, don't come off phone! Do the colors mean anything?
Well,
no.
You're close.
No. My brain ain't working. I don't know. Sure. There, time. This is a three-part deal. Let's see, glory to God.
This might be ESV.
That's
right? Like,
okay.
I mean, like, what version is this? Like, let's
that's
be real people.
New King James.
See, I memorized the NIV. Shout out to my mom.
Okay.
So, like, you know, it is what it is.
Oh my goodness, you won! I'm so excited. And her, of course, I'm excited because Pastor Lord.
Girls,
yay! Woo-hoo-hoo. Okay.
There's clearly a punctuation error here. I need another comma. Let's see, maybe on earth men peace?
That's a wrap.
Is that it? Earth men peace. Where does the goodwill go? Where does the goodwill? I'm gonna put the goodwill up top right now. The goodwill's gonna go up top, and then men, who has peace? Men.
We'll see you next year.
Men on towards, and peace towards men.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
From our Rock Kids family
to yours.
Bye, Rock Kids.